एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजी प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन ट्रेनिंग सिस्टम एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 40651। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। नाउ लेट्स सी द वर्किंग ऑफ दिस किट। सो वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म एन एक्सपेरिमेंट, दैट इज सिग्नल सैम्पलिंग्स एंड देयर रिकंस्ट्रक्शन। So in this experiment, we will study different types of signal samplings and their reconstruction. These are natural sampling, sample and hold, flat top sampling. So firstly, we have to do the connections. So we will connect the transmission clock port with the clock one port of the sampling like this. Then we will connect the 1 kilohertz port with the input 1 port of the sampling like this, and we have to keep all the switch fault at off position. So these are the switch fault keys and we have to keep them at off position. Now we have to keep the duty cycle at 50%. So this is the duty cycle switch and we have to keep it at 50%. So the first one at downside, second one at upside, third one at downside and fourth one at upside. So that is how we can keep the duty cycle at 50%. Now we will switch on the main kit. So this is the box that is provided with the kit to give the supply to this kit. So this is the wire through which we have connected this box and this kit so that this kit gets supply from this box. So here on the box we are having main power switch, so we have to on that switch and now our kit is on and it is ready for the experiments to be performed on. Now we have to keep the GP at GP1 position, so we will use this switch to keep the GP at GP1 position. So there are LEDs provided along all the GPs and you can set any GP by using this switch. So here in this experiment we have to set the GP at GP1 position, so we will keep this at GP1 position. Now we have to give sampling clock of frequency 8 kilohertz, so we will use this switch to keep it at 8 kilohertz. So we will set it at 8 kilohertz by using this S2 switch. So here also there are LEDs which indicates which frequency you are selecting. So with the help of this switch you can set any of this frequency. So in this experiment we have to keep the GP at GP1 position and the frequency at 8 kilohertz. Now we will switch on the DSO and we will connect the ground port of the DSO to the ground terminal of this kit and we will use this main probe of the DSO and we will firstly check the sine wave of 1 kilohertz. So we will keep this at 1 kilohertz port and now we will use this P5 port to keep the sine wave at its maximum. So here you can see that the waveform appears on the DSO. This is the 1 kilohertz waveform. You can change the amplitude by varying this port. So I am keeping it at maximum. Now we will check the 8 kilohertz clock. So for that we will keep this main probe at clock 1. So here on the DSO you can see that the waveform appears. This is the 8 kilohertz clock waveform. Now we will see the output and we will adjust all these parameters of 1V and 200 micro S as mentioned in the manual. So these parameters are mentioned in the manual. We have to set these parameters according to the waveforms. So for output, natural sampling output, we will keep this probe at output 1. So here you can see that on the DSO, this waveform is the natural sampling output. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will see the waveform of sample and hold. So for that, the connections will be remain same, just we need to change the jumper position of JP1. So at the first experiment, we kept this at first position of natural sampling. Now we will shift this to at second position, that is sample and hold position. So now we will see the sample and hold position waveform. So similarly, firstly we will check the sine wave of 1 kHz. So you can adjust the sine wave amplitude by using this P5 port. Now we will check the clock waveform. So again you can check the clock waveform at clock 1 port of the sampling. Now we will check the output of this sample and hold. So we will keep the main probe of this DSO at the output of 1, that is present in the sampling section. So we will keep this at out 1 port like this. And here on the DSO, you can see that this waveform appears, and this is the sample and hold waveform. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now you can check the waveform for flat top sampling. So for that, again the connection will be remain same, we just need to switch the jumper position. And now for this experiment, we have to keep this jumper position at third position, that is the flat top sampling. Now again we will check the sine wave of 1 kHz at the 1 kHz port, and we will check the clock pulse. So here on the DSO you can see that the waveforms appears, and now we will check the output. So this is the flat top sampling output, and we have to adjust this at 1 volt. And 200 mu s. So that's the waveform appears on the DSO. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study effect of duty cycle. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the transmission clock port with the clock 1 port of the sampling like this. Then we will connect the 1 kHz port to the input port of the sampling like this. And we have to keep all the switch fault at off position, and we have to keep the duty cycle at 90%. So for that we have to keep the first switch at down, and then second at up, third at up, and the fourth at down. So that is how you can keep the duty cycle at 90%. The first one down, the second one up, the third one up, and the fourth one again down. So that is how the duty cycle is at 90%. Now we will switch on the main kit. Now we will again adjust the GP positions. So we will use the S1 switch, and we will keep the GP position at GP1 like this. Now we have to keep the frequency at 8 kHz. So we will again use this S2 switch, and we will keep it at 8 kilohertz like this. Now we will switch on the DSO and we will keep the ground port at ground port of this gate and the main terminal at the 1 kilohertz port of the kit. So now on the DSO you can see the sine wave of 1 kilohertz, and you can adjust this sine wave by using this P5 port. So I am keeping it at maximum. Now we will check the 8 kilohertz duty cycle. So for that we will keep this main cord at the clock 1 position like this. So here on the DSO you can see that the waveform appears, that is the 8 kilohertz 90% duty cycle. Now we will check the natural sampling output. So we have to keep the jumper 1 position at first, that is the natural sampling, and now we will check the output. So this is the natural sampling output, and you can see the output on the DSO. So that is how this experiment is performed, and you can check the output for different duty cycle, like for 10%, for 50%, and for 70%, and for 20%. Likewise, and you can see the waveform at the output port like this. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study effect of order of the low pass filter. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the transmission clock port with the clock 1 port of the sampling like this. Then we will connect the 1 kilohertz function generator port with the input port of the sampling like this. Then we will connect the output 1 of the sampling with the input 33 port like this. Then we will connect the output 30 port with the input 34 port like this, and we have to keep all the switch fault at off position, and we have to keep the duty cycle at 50%. So again we will change the position of the duty cycle, and we have to keep it at 50%. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main supply, and now we have to again keep the GP at GP1 position. So we will use the S1 switch and we will keep it at GP1. Now we will use S2 switch and we will keep the frequency at again 8 kilohertz. And now again we will connect the ground port of the DSO with the ground terminal and the main probe to the 1 kilohertz sine wave port of the function generator. So again we will adjust the sine wave through this P5 port. So you can see on the DSO the sine wave appears of 1 kilohertz. Now we will check the natural sampling of 8 kilohertz, that is 50% clock. So that is the output of the natural sampling. So you can check the output at the output 1 port of the sampling. So you have to connect the main probe to this output 1 port of the sampling. So here on the DSO you can see that the natural sampling waveform is like this. Now we will see the recovered output at second order filter. So we will check this at output port 30. So we have to adjust this at 200 mu s. So this is the recovered output at second order filter. You can see the waveform on the DSO, and we are checking this output at output 30 port. This is the second order filter output. Now we will check it for fourth order filter at output port 31. So here on the DSO you can see that the recovered output waveform at fourth order filter is this, and we are checking this at output 31. So that is how this experiment is performed, and you can check it for sample and hold also. Just we have to change the jumper position to second one, and we can check it for flat and top. So for that the connection will be remain same, just we have to change the jumper position to third one, and that is how you can get the waveform on the DSO. And that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study time division multiplexing with different receiver synchronization techniques. And in this experiment we will study direct synchronization technique. So first of all we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the 250 Hz port of the function generator with the input 7 port of the 4 channel mux like this. Then we will connect the 500 Hz port with the input port 8. Similarly we will connect the 1 kHz port with the input port 9. Then we will connect the 2 kHz port with the input port 10 like this. Then we will connect the output port of the 4 channel mux with the input port of the 4 channel DMUX, that is input port 23. Then we will connect all the output ports of the 4 channel DMUX to all the input ports of the 4th order filter like this. So we have to connect all the output ports of the 4 channel DMUX to the input ports of the 4th order filter. Like this. Now we will connect the transmission clock port with the receiver clock, and we will connect the transmission synchronization port with the receiver synchronization port like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main gate, and now we will use this S1 switch, and we will keep GP at GP2. Now we will switch on the DSO, and we will connect the ground port to the ground one, and now we will connect the main cord to the 250 Hz. So you can see the waveform on the DSO. This is the 250 Hz sine wave, then this is the 500 Hz, then this is the 1 kHz, then this is the 2 kHz waveform. Now we will check the test points, which are test point 1, test point 2, test point 3 and test point 4. So this is the waveform of the test point 1, then this is the waveform of the test point 2, then this is the waveform of the test point 3, and this is the waveform of the test point 4. So these are the test points of 4 channel mux. Now we will see the output of the 4 channel mux. So we will connect the main cord to the output 5 of the 4 channel mux, and you can see the waveform on the DSO. Now we will see the output of the 4 channel DMUX. So the first output is this, then the second output is this, then the third output is this, and then the fourth output is this. Now we will check the recovered waveform. So this is the first recovered waveform, then this is the second recovered waveform, then this is the third recovered waveform, then this is the fourth recovered waveform. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study time division multiplexing with different receiver synchronization techniques. So in this experiment we will study direct synchronization technique. So first of all we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the 250 Hz with the input 7 port, then we will connect the 500 Hz with the input 8 port, then we will connect the 1 kilohertz with the input port 9, then we will connect the 2 kilohertz with the input port 10, then we will connect the output port 5 of the 4 channel multiplexer with the input port 4 channel demultiplexer. Then we will connect all the outputs of 4 channel demultiplexer with the inputs of 4th order filter like this. So we have to connect all the outputs of the 4 channel demultiplexer with the inputs of 4th order filter like this. Now we will connect the transmission clock with the receiver clock and the transmission synchronization with the receiver synchronization like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main gate and we will use this S1 switch and we will keep it at GP2. Now we will switch on the DSO and we will connect the ground port to the ground one, and now we will measure the 250 Hz sine wave, then we will measure the 500 Hz sine wave, then we will measure the 1 kilohertz sine wave, then we will measure the 2 kilohertz sine wave, then we will check all the test points of 4 channel mux. So this is the test point 1, then this is the test point 2, then this is the test point 3, then this is the test point 4 waveform. Now we will check the output of the 4 channel mux. So this is the output port 5 of the 4 channel mux and you can see the waveform on the DSO. Now we will check the output of the 4 channel demux. So this is the first output, then this is the second output, then this is the third output, then this is the fourth output, and now we will check the fourth order filter output. This is the recovered waveform. So this is the first recovered waveform, then this is the second, then this is the third, then this is the fourth. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study pulse code modulation and demodulation technique. So in this experiment we will study direct synchronization technique. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the P3 port of the function generator 250 Hz with the ADC input port like this. Then we will connect the transmission data port with the receiver data port like this. Then we will connect the DAC output port with the input 33 port like this. Then we will connect the output 30 port and the input 34 port like this. Then we will connect the transmission clock with the receiver clock then we will connect the transmission synchronization port with the receiver synchronization port. And here we have to change this jumper position, that is jumper 3 position, to fast. So we have to keep the jumper like this. The position of jumper is mentioned in the manual. So you have to keep the jumper position like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main gate and we will use this S1 switch and we will keep GP at GP3 position. Now we will switch on the DSO and we will connect the ground port with the ground port, and we will connect the main probe with the firstly 250 hertz sine wave. So here you can see that on the DSO sine wave appears. Now we will check the transmitter clock. So we will keep the main probe of the DSO to the transmission clock port like this, and you can see the transmission clock on the DSO. So this is the transmission clock waveform. Now we will see the transmission synchronization clock. So we have to reduce this margin, and here you can see that the transmission synchronization waveform is this and the transmission clock waveform is this. Now we will check the DAC output. So this is the DAC output waveform, and now we will check the second order filter. So this is the second order filter. Now we will check the recovery at output 31. So this is the recovered waveform. Now we will check the PIBS output. So there is a test point given at PIBS output. So here we will just touch the main cord to that knob. And you can see that on the DSO, the waveform of PIBS output appears. So this is the output waveform which we get from this experiment. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study effect of parities and Hamming code on PCM data. So in this experiment we will study the fast mode with DC signal even parity PCM. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the P7 port of function generator with the ADC in port like this. Then we will connect the transmission data port with the receiver data port like this. Then we will connect the DAC output port with the input 33 port like this. Then we will connect the output 30 port with the input 34 port like this. Then we will connect the transmission clock port with the receiver clock port like this. Then we will connect the transmission synchronization port with the receiver synchronization port like this. And we have to keep the jumper 3 position at fast position like this, and we have to keep all the error code switches at off position and all the switch fault switches at off position. So that is how the connection is done. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the main gate and we will use this S1 switch and we will keep GP at GP3 position. Now here on the S11 switch, this is the error code switch. So here we will generate an error. So you can see the error correction and the error coded data and the parity coded data LED lights changes. So this occurs because of the fault we have done in this error code switch. So you can take readings according to that and you can form the observation table. So you can see the observation table in the manual also. So this is the observation table and you can do the changes according to the manual. Like you can change any of the four ports of the switches and you can create any error and you can get the LED readings according to that. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study various data encoding and decoding techniques. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the transmission clock with the clock 2 port of the encoded data. Then we will connect the S data port with the input data 16 port like this. Then we will connect the output port with the input 27 port. And we have to keep all the switch fault at off position. And we have to keep the S data switch as first, second down, then third, fourth, fifth up, then sixth down, then seventh up, and then eighth down. So that is how you need to keep the S4 switch position. That is the S data switch. Now we will switch on the main gate as the connection is done. Now we will use this S1 switch to keep GP at GP4 position. Now we will switch on the DSO and we will connect the ground port to the ground port of the kit and we will first check the transmission clock. So we will connect the main probe of the DSO to the transmission clock. So this is the transmission clock pulse. You can see it on the DSO. This is the transmission clock waveform. Then we will check the S data waveform. So this is the S data waveform. Then we will check the input 16 waveform. Then we will check the clock waveform. Then we will check the output of the encoded data. So this is the output of the encoded data. So this is the transmitter clock. Then this is the simulated 8-bit data. That is the output port 10. Then we will check the NIZL encoded data. So at output 10, this is the NIZL output data. Now we will check the recovered clock. So for that, we will go to data decoder and there is a recovered clock too. So we will connect the main probe of the DSO to that port. And here on the DSO, you can see that the recovered clock waveform looks like this. And now we will check the decoded data, that is the output 23 port. So on the DSO you can see the output 23 port. So this is the decoded data waveform. So that is how this experiment is performed. You can check the waveforms for NIZM, NIZS and BIOL, BIOM, BIOS. Just you need to press this S4 switch and you can change the positions of NIZL to NIZM to NIZS and vice versa. And you can see the waveforms on the DSO with this same connections. So that is how you can perform this experiment. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.